Hey guys, what is up? It is Castle Perfect here bringing you another Wi-Fi battle live. This time I'm battling the big ass YouTuber, as we all know, you know, Hudlums Crafty. And today I'm going to be using a new team as well, so it will be a bigger challenge for me to, you know, play against Scrafty, because this is, oh my god. I've never battled him before. But my last battle that I had was against somebody, and I basically 6-0 him with Luna, which is going to be my Clefable. And, you know, I didn't really get to utilize the team to its entire potential, so hopefully Column will be a good challenge, a good exercise for future references and future adjustments to my team. So let's go ahead and take a picture real quick of his team, because of course that's what I always do. Okay, that one was quite blurry, and this one is blurry too. Come on, focus. Why is you not focusing? All right, there you go. There it goes. That's good. All right, so I got a picture. And I am set. So it's got a Jirachi, Gudra, a Mien Shao, I believe. Starmie, Breloom, and a Evilite Doublade. All right, so I now need to think what is going to lead off. He's most likely going to lead off with his Mien Shao, because those things like to fake out. Not to mention, they like to U-turn as well. So I might as well just go ahead and lead off with my Crobat, which is going to be the fastest thing on my team. And it can basically just go for the Brave Bird after taking the fake out. Of course, I am not, I do not have the ability Inner Focus, unfortunately. I do have Infiltrator on my Crobat, meaning that I can hit through subs. But other than that, I will be flinching when he uses the fake out, which is what I'm thinking he's going to do, of course. So let's go ahead and see what he does. I'm going to lead up with my Crobat, which is good. I don't have a name for him just yet, or her, actually. It's actually a female. If you have a good nickname for my Crobat, just pretty much put it down in the comment section below. I always read my comments. I reply to whatever question you have. And I almost forgot, though. If you guys want more live commentated Wi-Fi battles from me daily, you know, let's hit 40 likes on this one. Just 40 likes, it's simple. I mean, I got almost 6,000 subscribers, so 40 likes shouldn't be a problem, right? So 40 likes for this video, and I'll be uploading daily live Wi-Fi battles. So let's go ahead and get started. He's going to lead off with a Mien Shao, just like I predicted. He's got a Doublade on his team, and the, what is it? Okay, so going for the U-turn would be a good thing, but then again, I would like to go for the Brave Bird, just to do as much damage as I can. I'm not sure, though. He's gonna go for the Brave Bird, he's gonna go for the Fake God, I'm sure. Alright, he's gonna go for the U-turn, straight away, he's gonna go out into his Doublade. I should have gone for the U-turn. That was a really bad move on my part. Okay, so his Doublade is going to take that Brave Bird like a monster, and most likely because of the amount of damage that I'll be doing, he might just discover, oh, that's a shiny, whoa, that's a really awesome shiny though. I'm just going to go for the Brave Bird here. He is most likely going to discover that I'm Choice Banded because the amount, well, actually not. That thing is quite bulky. Holy crap, it doesn't do anything. So I'm just going to switch. I don't know what that thing does though. I have no idea. It's got pretty bad special defense, that much I know. So I'm thinking of switching out into Pinkfeon, seeing as how she is a fairy type and she can take, you know, fighting type attacks and such as Sacred Sword and, you know, ghost type attacks to a certain extent. So she's gonna go for the Gyro Ball. That is not going to do that much damage, considering the fact that my Sylveon is not. Whoa! Never mind. Never mind. That does way too much. Holy shit! Oh my god, that does so much damage. I did not expect that. And yeah, I'm in a world of trouble right now. This thing is really scary. Oh my! What? So much damage! Wow. That is crazy. Wow, I'm absolutely, wow, this is, I'm in a bad situation right off the bat. So I'm going to switch out into the Thug, which is going to be Scrafty. And it's funny because his mascot is Scrafty as well, so he'll have to face Scrafty this time. And this Scrafty is actually really different. It's really, really different from all the other scraps that you've ever seen in your entire life. And I'll show you guys why in a minute. So it's gonna go into Gudra, which is, you know, that's fine. He's most likely going to drop a Draco Meteor on me. But I'm just gonna go for the Thief. Yes, you heard me right. I'm gonna go for the Thief because this is a set, you know, that I thought of would be fun to use. It's not like one of those try hard sets. It's just like a fun thing that I thought of. I'm just going for the Thief, stealing the held items of my opposition and, you know, pretty much flinging them away. So I'm basically throwing their items away. And I can, you know, steal them back again with another Thief. So I'm just going to go for the Thief here. I'm going to take the item from that Gudra. That is going to be Assault Fest. That's perfect, actually. That is actually really, really good. I'm going to go for a Drain Punch right now. I mean, I could go for a Fling, which is fine as well. So it's going to go for the Draco Meteor. That's not going to do that much damage, I think, because I do have the Assault Fest right now. All right, so that's not going to kill me. His special attack is going to drop. I'm just going to go ahead and hit him with a Drain Punch here. Recover a little bit of HP. Not enough, actually, now that I think about it. Not enough, and I don't want to lose this guy just yet. All right, so will he switch? That's the question. Most likely, because he's most likely going to predict the... what is it? The Drain Punch again, so... Okay. Yeah, I need to think right now. All right, you know what? I'm just going to go out into Luna, which is going to be my fairy type Pokemon, just like Pinkfeon. She's going to be able to take a Draco Meteor if he decides to go for another one. No, he's going to switch out here, which is very smart. I would have done the same thing. So he's going to go out into this thing. All right, that's not good. That's not good. I mean, I'm pure fairy type, I believe. I'm not sure. I think that Clefable lost its normal typing and just became full fairy. Yeah, it's actually a full fairy type. That's perfect. I am going to... Oh, man. He's going to go for the fake out, isn't he? Well, whatever the case, I'm just going to go for the cosmic power here. He might just go for... Oh, no, okay. So he's going to go for the U-turn. And he's most likely going to go out into his Gudra because he's got the sludge bomb. And that's super effective against, you know, Clefable. But again, I'm thinking that if he goes out into that Pokemon, I can always just retaliate with a Moonblast. But I'm not sure if I'm faster. That's the question. I think that Gudra is a little bit faster. Oh, never mind. We've got the Jirachi. I forgot about the Jirachi here. I need to take a look at the pictures because I'm not looking at the picture. I'm not looking at the picture. I am playing bad. He's going to go for the Iron Head. And that's not good. Oh, he might just go for the Thunder Wave, though, predicting the switch. Will I risk? Yeah, I'm going to risk it. Really bad, but I really want to find out if he's going to go for the Iron. I'm just going to go for the Flamethrower here. All right, so he's going to go for the Iron Head. Hopefully that does not take me out. Yeah, that doesn't take me out, but he doesn't get the flinch, which is absolutely perfect. I'm going to go for the Flamethrower. That is going to do quite a lot of damage. And now, he's absolutely going to predict the switch. Now, the thing is, I'm not sure if that Jirachi has a Thunder Punch, but I'm going to find out. I'm just going to switch out into Empoleon, aka my Napoleon. And that Pokemon will most likely, you know, hopefully do something. It will hopefully do something. I need to start playing better though, because I don't want to get swept or something. I don't want to be 6-0'd. That'd be terrible. So, okay. Alright, let me think. He's got a Breloom, a Gudra, which can pretty much take hits really hard. Alright, so I got leftovers on this guy. And I could go for the agility, but I don't think that I'll be outspeeding the Nian Shao, but he's most likely going to switch out into Starmie, which would actually make a lot of sense considering the fact that Starmie walls Empoleon quite a lot. But if he's gonna do that, then I should absolutely make a double switch into Crobat. But the thing is, you know, it's Column, so he might just switch out into his Doublade at this point. Decisions. Or he might just, for the same fact, just stay in and go for the Thunder Punch. That would totally suck. I have so much troubles with like legendaries and stuff. Right. What to do? I'm just gonna double switch into Crobat. I'm just gonna do that. Hopefully it doesn't have the Thunder Punch because that would totally suck. If that's the case, I lost the game. So it's gonna go for the Wish. Which, oh my, I should have stayed. I should have stayed in. I so should have stayed in. Oh my god. This sucks. Alright, so I'm gonna go for a U-turn then. And I'm just gonna go back into Napoleon. Because quite frankly, I cannot hurt this thing. So U-turn, just deal a little bit of damage. And okay. I am going to send out Napoleon one more time. I don't know if he's gonna switch. No, he's not gonna switch, obviously. He's just going to attack me. Oh, he's gonna set up Stealth Rocks. Okay, so this is a setup Jirachi with possibly only Iron Head. So he's got Wish, he's got Stealth Rocks, Iron Head, and his last move would be maybe Protect? No, Protect wouldn't make sense. I don't know. I do have Defog though on my Crobat, but my Crobat destroy is banded. I have Defog there for just emergency. Okay, so I'm just gonna go for the Hydro Pump now. I just don't care about it anymore. He's gonna go for the Wish. I'm not sure why. I think he just wants to scout out my move pool in a way. That would make sense, I guess. Alright, so Hydro Pump does not do that much damage, and this Jirachi is really going to be the biggest nightmare I've ever faced so far with this team. This is actually the second battle that this team is in, or is participating in, so it needs quite a lot of polishment, meaning that this team is not complete. I need to change a couple of things here and there. So, alright, so I'm thinking he will wish. He will pass this wish into something, and something that counters my Empoleon, and something that counters my Empoleon at this point would be Goodra or Starmie. Yeah, Goodra or Starmie. Okay, so I'm just gonna double again. I'm going to switch out into Gallade. He's most likely going to switch as well. And if he doesn't switch out, then again, I'm lost. I'm predicting things that he's not doing. And I'm just doing. I'm playing bad, I guess. He goes for the. What the fuck, man? What are you doing, Colm? What are you doing, dude? You're just making me look bad right now. All right, I'm just gonna stop with the predictions. Screw this. I'm gonna go back into Empoleon. And I am basically just going to Hydro Pump away. That's what I'm gonna do. Oh no, wait, I'm just gonna go for the Ice Beam and try to get a freeze. That's what I'm gonna do. That is exactly what I'm gonna do. So it's gonna go for the Iron Head, I guess, on this turn. I mean, that would be better. That would have done more. Okay, so it's gonna go for the Wish. And oh my god, Colm, stop being a nightmare. Stop being a nightmare. Stop being a nightmare. Alright, so Leftover is gonna get me back to full health. I am just going to spam the Ice Beams right now. Screw that. Alright, he's gonna go for the Body Slam, trying to get the Para Hex, of course, and then he's gonna proceed to go for the Iron Head and get the Para Flinch going on. But if we're actually going to fish for Hex, I'm going to do the same thing. Alright, so Leftovers and the Wish is gonna get him back to full. Whatever. I'm just gonna see where this is gonna take us. I mean, he's got a Doublet, which can take that Ice Beam pretty well. But nothing else on his team. Well, except for Starmie, obviously. I don't know if he's gonna switch. No, he's not gonna switch. He's gonna get the Para Hex on this thing. He's gonna get it right now. Yep, there goes. There goes Serena Grace activating, and I'm gonna be par. No, okay. No, I'm not gonna be paralyzed. He's not gonna get the first turn Hex. I'm gonna continue to go for the Ice Beam, and still I'm not getting that freeze. I need to get that freeze in order to win this game, otherwise I'm just going to lose. This Jirachi basically walls my entire team, and that sucks. And I just discovered that this team doesn't have any ground-type moves. Alright, I'm in a world of trouble, so it's gonna go for the Iron Head here. It's gonna pretty much spam things. If not, he's gonna switch out. Or he might just go for the Wish, and then switch out a turn after to pass the Wish, of course. That makes sense. But passing a wish into Gudra would be horrible. All I need is to... Really, I just need to set up on him. One time. One time, but I don't think he's going to allow me to do that. He is not going to allow me to do that. As long as this thing exists... As long as this Jirachi is around, then there is really no end to this phase off here. Alright, so come on, get the freeze, man. Come on, get the freeze. That's all I'm asking. Get the freeze. Freeze the Jirachi. Give me a chance to do something. That's all I'm asking for right now. So the Iron Head is really not doing that much damage because it's 4 times resisted. So I don't think he's gonna do that. I don't think he's going to stay in and continuously go for Iron Head. I mean, that would just be nah. Oh, he's gonna go for the wish, and I'm pretty certain he's gonna switch on the next turn. Or maybe he's baiting me into believing that he's gonna do. Okay, I get the Pyro Hex this time. Fair enough. Fair enough. Fair enough. Okay, so leftover is gonna happen. And yeah, what will he switch out? That's a good question. I mean, his Dublade would be a good choice. Alright, so you know what? Screw this. I'm going to predict the switch. And if this time he doesn't switch out, then I don't know it anymore. I really don't know. He is going to... Okay, so he's going to switch into most likely his Starmie or Dublade. Starmie or Dublade, one of those two. Then what should I go out into? You know what it is? My walls are almost dead, all of them. If he goes out into Dublade, then... Alright, so I'm going to predict the switch into Dublade. I'm going to stay and I'm just going to go for the Hydro Pump. I'm just going to go for the Hydro Pump. He's going to go over. That's going to be the Gudra, right? Ah, crap. Should have gone for the Ice Beam. Damn it! Screw you, Callum. Alright, so the wish is going to be passed. And shit is going to suck. Okay. Okay. I know what you did there. Okay, so you have Sludge Bomb, Draco Meteor, Thunderbolt is possibly going to be the next move. And if that's going to be the case, then... okay. So I don't have... Oh, I forgot. I have a Focus Sash from Gallade. Well, I thought I had something else. Close Combat, Psycho Cut, and Shadow Sneak. The Sish. Okay, so. Okay, no. He's gonna go. He might predict the switch into Pink Field. That's the thing. And he might just go for the Sludge Bomb. Nah, I don't think he's gonna do that. You know, whatever. I'm just gonna switch out into Pink Field here. Because I don't want him to go for the Thunderbolt and finish me off right away. Alright, so pretty stupid Stealth Rocks is going to happen. He's going to go for the Thunderbolt, that's fine. That is going to take me out. Makes sense. I don't have that much HP to live through that. Alright. Keep on rolling. Alright, so I'm going to go out into Luna. Alright, so I'm going to go out into Luna here. Oh, crap. Wait. What did I do? What did I do? I did not meant to... Oh, fuck. I am completely... This is bad. This is so bad. Okay. Okay. Just gonna go for the Moonlight here, because... Yeah, it's gonna go for the Sludge Bomb. The thing... How fast is that thing? Screw this, man. This is going really bad. I should not have used this team against him. I mean, god damn it. Alright, so I'm going to go out into Gallade now. I'll take a little bit of Stealth Rocks damage there. He might just go for the Draco Meteor just to finish me off, so... the Draco Meteor will kill me. But he might predict the close combat, right? And go out into Dublade. I'm just going to stop predicting stuff. I'm just going to go for the close combat. Screw this. Oh my god, Callum! What are you doing, dude? Oh, I wanted to go for the Sword Dance so badly. I'm just gonna go for the Sword Dance this time, then. Just gonna go for the Sword Dance, see what happens. I know the Dublade has a shit ton of defense, though. He's gonna go for the sword as himself. Alright, so he's got Gyro Ball. And most likely Shadow Sneak. I mean, why would he not use Shadow Sneak? I'm gonna go for the Shadow Sneak myself. Just deal some super effective damage and hopefully do a little bit of damage. Because quite frankly, I don't think I'm gonna be doing that much damage. Wow, are you serious, dude? Are you serious? Okay, so I'm getting my ass whooped here. This is kind of a shitty move, though. Okay, Gollum, okay, fine. I should have not used a team that I'm not familiar with. Okay. Yeah, I'm dead. I mean, I lost this game already. That's bad, though. That's really bad, though. He's gonna go for the Defog here. He's probably gonna go for the Sword Dance again. No, he's gonna go for the Shadow Sneak. Alright, that might kill me. Yeah, that's gonna kill me. Alright, that's not gonna kill me. I'm gonna go for the Defog here. Just to get rid of the Stealth Rock so I can bring out the Thog. And I don't know if I'm gonna be able to live through a Shadow Sneak. But hey, I'm gonna try it. So he's gonna go for another Shadow Sneak. Makes sense. It makes sense. And I have two Pokemon left. Right. Okay. Well, yeah, Jirachi. That was so painful. Jirachi is such a big freaking wall to this team. It's incredible. Okay, fine. I'm just gonna go for the fling. I mean I cannot do anything else really. He's gonna go for the Shadow Sneak and take me out, most likely. I would have done the same thing. I'm gonna fling that Assault Fest over there. Screw you. It's super effective, but it still doesn't do that much damage. Alright, it's gonna take me out with the Sacred Sword. And that is going to be a good game, I guess, because I think that Doublade is faster than Napoleon. So he'll just kill me, and wow, this game sucks balls, man. He just 6-0'd my ass. He 6-0'd my ass. That's painful to watch. This is painful to watch, dude. This is painful to watch. Alright, Colm. Alright. Good game, dude. Good game. You played well, I played shitty. I shouldn't be using too many fairy-type Pokemon on my team. That should be a lesson. Jirachi, man. Jirachi. What the fuck? Why would you even bother to switch out, dude? Just Sacred Sword me. Had a +2 attack. What was the point? Get a little bit of leftovers recovery. I'm kind of quiet because of this. This is terrible. This is so fucking horrible, actually. I've never... Like, I believe that I've lost, like, a total of 6 or 7 times in total in my entire YouTube career, and I've never been defeated like this before, like this badly. That's wow. I mean, I need to laugh about it because I'm thinking, if I'm going to go up against somebody like Colm, why would I bring something that I'm not familiar with? It does not make sense. It doesn't even make sense in my own head. So why did I do it? Well, whatever, that's gonna be the game. I got 6-0, I got my ass handed to me. Good game, Colm, you played very well. So everybody, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully next time that doesn't happen, and yeah, that's gonna be it, guys. Take care.